Does this toothbrush 2020 meet your needs? Hey everyone, welcome to the BME Life. My name is Betty and today we're going to be talking about product development of medical devices. Product development, in very basic words, is the process of taking an idea into the market. There's basically five main phases, and for the purpose of this video, we're going to be pretending to be a startup. Say that we have talked to a number of dentists and they come to us with a medical problem. People don't like toothpaste. People are not brushing their teeth because they don't like using toothpaste because it tastes bad, because of the consistency, because it's expensive, for whatever reason. People just don't want to use toothpaste anymore. Cavities start to happen. There's infections in the mouth. You know, there's all kinds of problems going on. Our need that the doctors bring is toothpaste-less solution to brushing your teeth. As biomedical engineers, we need to come up with a solution to this medical need. So we say, we are going to bring a toothbrush that does not require toothpaste. But the toothbrush is gonna release some chemical or drug that is gonna replace whatever the toothpaste had, and it's gonna benefit the teeth and everything's gonna be awesome without toothpaste. So we're calling this the toothbrush 2020. Now that we have an idea, we enter the first phase, which is initiation, opportunity, and risk analysis. In this phase, we basically look at what is our market potential. Are we actually gonna benefit as a company creating this product? Look at the market. Who are our biggest competitors, which are probably Colgate, Crest. We look at what kind of regulatory pathway would we enter. We look at what is our potential revenue. So we need to be realistic of how much this could actually benefit. What is the cost? How much money are we gonna ask from investors? How much are we getting back? What is our timeline? It's probably many, many years. What is the risk of us failing? Also, if our product is a novel product that has never been seen before, we would probably want to file for an intellectual property patent to make sure that no one copies our product. The next phase is formulation, concept, and feasibility. We already assessed the risk, assessed the market, and now we're going to be looking at what is our device going to look like. We have to start prototyping, designing, we have to start all the SolidWorks drawings, we have to choose the materials that we're going to use, choose the manufacturers that are going to be building our device, start thinking of assembly protocols and things like that. Basically, just start conceptualizing our device and what it's going to look like. And our design is going to be driven by the customer requirements that we got from the dentist, the customers that we interviewed, and things like that. So in this phase, it's very important to listen to the voice of the customer. And this, if you're a biomedical engineer, this is a term that you should know. It's really important to listen to what they want and implement it into your device by interviews, surveys, or research. Now that we have our device and its design, we can enter the design, verification, and validation phase, also known as V&V. To start, what is usually done is creating a traceability matrix. A traceability matrix is basically the blueprint of your device and how it meets the customer requirements that were translated into engineering requirements, which are then verified by testing. So for example, we mentioned that our customer wanted a long battery life for the toothbrush. And we as engineers, we said we're giving 30 days. But you need to create a testing protocol to how you're going to be testing that and all the other requirements that drive your design. Other tests that also go along with verification include tests such as electrical safety testing, which all electrical devices have to go through to verify that they're safe for the user. Electromagnetic compatibility testing to verify that, you know, things like frequencies from the phones or just things around us will not interfere with the performance of the device. And then there's also IP rating testing to verify that no fluids or solid particles will interfere with the performance. There's also shipping simulation, extreme temperature simulations, just to verify that your device will endure things like storage or shelf life, for example. And along with verification, we mentioned that we have validation. So this is where we bring the device to the customer and we ask them, does it meet your requirements and your needs? So this is where the customer comes in and they say, yes, this device does what I want it to do. Adrian, does this toothbrush 2020 meet your needs?
I don't usually like toothbrush or toothpaste, but hey, this is actually, I like this. This is perfect. This is exactly what I wanted. Everything I was looking for in the toothbrush. This is amazing. Thank you so much.
Now remember, while we're gathering all these tests and data, we are collecting all the information needed to file to the FDA to get clearance in our device. We cannot go into the market until we get FDA clearance. And the FDA actually requires for 3 months of testing data to be able to complete your submission. Now phase four is final validation and launch preparation. So you're finishing up all your tests, all your biocompatibility, electrical safety, performance testing, shipping testing, packaging testing, all the tests. You're gathering all the necessary documents for FDA submission, such as your design history file, your device master record, a description of your device. You also need to take into consideration that once you get FDA approval, you're going into the market. So you want to have enough products to sell once you enter the market. So you need to make an analysis of how many products you would expect to sell, how much you have to scale up in your manufacturing, and have all those products ready to go. And the final phase is phase five, which is product launch. Congratulations, your toothbrush 2020 was FDA cleared. You can now sell it, and you can start making revenue. Now, don't forget that once you go into the market, you need to have a post-product launch or post-market plan. How are you gonna acquire feedback from the customers that you can implement into your device for maybe Gen 2 designs or just for continuous improvement of your device? Now, one thing that we must not forget is that we are a startup. This whole process probably took us about 10 years from our initial idea to the final market approval. This means that we probably needed a lot of money for funding, probably millions of dollars, not only for manufacturing or prototyping, but also for all the other costs like testing, rent, everything, employees, your own salary, everything is money, time is money. So you needed a good series of funding in the beginning. Where did you get this fund from? Probably investors. We also have to take into consideration that at any time now, we probably will get acquired by a company like we mentioned before, like Colgate or Crest. So now that our product is approved, all this time along, Colgate and Crest have had us under their microscopes. They've been looking at us and our development. And now that we're approved and risk-free, well, maybe not risk-free, but definitely low-risk company, they are interested in acquiring us. But like I mentioned, we had investors in the beginning, we have the founders, and if we have any employees, they probably all have shares. And once we get acquired by the bigger company, they're going to buy us according to the market value that we possess at the moment. So because we are already in the market, we're probably very valuable, and you want to be able to, you know, be smart about when you are exiting the company. An exit strategy of being acquired is very common for startups, so that's probably something we would do. And once we get acquired by a bigger company, we agree on the price that we're selling our company for, where we both parties can benefit, then the shares are distributed and everyone's happy. That's pretty much it for product development of medical devices. There's a lot of details in between each phase, and even between phases, there's even more details. So I hope you learned something. I'm definitely not an expert in this, so let me know if I messed up somewhere. But I do have over a year of experience as a product development engineer at a medical device startup. So it's an area that I've become really passionate about, and I would love to learn more about it. Let me know if you're interested in it and if you'd like me to talk more about it, and I'll be definitely making a video on what I specifically do at my company as a product development engineer. This was it for this video. Make sure to comment, like, and subscribe, and share, and follow us on Instagram, Twitter, join the Facebook group, and follow us on our new TikTok account. Everything at the BME Life. Thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye. Wait, I know. Adrian.
I'll get it for you. Right.
No, I know. Like, bring me a toothbrush, and I'm gonna be, Adrian, does this meet your needs? And then when you start, you're gonna grab it from the camera.
Yeah. Okay.